looks like from the front after the storm.
So you've got the whole event before, after, ground level.
That's correct.
After posting some of his work on social media, he was inundated with requests. More than 700 came from a densely populated, spiraling development 35 miles north of Sanibel called Rotunda West.
This is Rotunda West. This is the neighborhood. And the pink dots that you see are each individual image that was taken in the neighborhood.
To build his database, Quinn incorporated satellite images with ground-level pictures he took driving street by street.
So that huge circle that we saw, you're going down every cul-de-sac, going up and down, getting pictures on both sides of the street?
Every road, every house.
How long did that take you?
It took me 9 hours, 117 miles.
And how many pictures did you end up with?
Just over 8,000.
He filmed inside some houses.
Oh, man.
Quinn's efforts didn't go unnoticed.
It's a foot deep, and I'm going to have to turn back.
He told us he's been contacted by an insurance company and Florida's Emergency Operations Center seeking his data.
Why'd you do this?
If you've ever felt hopelessness or despair or the anxiety that comes with the unknown, you know it's a terrible feeling. We know that we can use technology in a way that really hasn't been used before to get to the right audience, to get to the loved ones and family members. We want to quell that anxiety for them.
A prescription for that may lie 12 miles northeast of hard-hit Fort Myers. Babcock Ranch is the brainchild of eco-conscious developer and former professional football player Sid Kitson.
So when you look at this building, this just went through a Cat 4 hurricane.
Kitson and his partners purchased 91,000 acres in 2006, bigger than Manhattan, with a dream to build America's first environmentally friendly, hurricane-proof, fully sustainable small town.
We are the first solar-powered town in America. We have a solar field that's 150 megawatts, but that's just part of the story.
How many people live here now?
About 5,000 people, and it'll eventually be 50.
Plans to grow to what?
About 50,000 people.
Kitson rode out the storm in his lakeside home in town.
And I remember sitting here, I had the weather on, and the weather person says, well, this Category 4 hurricane is now heading for Babcock Ranch. And not only is it heading for Babcock Ranch, but it's going to be on the eastern side of the wall, which is the worst place to be.
How long did the hurricane sit over?
It's about 8 to 10 hours.
Just run unbelievable. You can barely hear yourself think.
He took this video with his iPhone. At the height of the tempest, there were white caps on the lake.
So as soon as the sun came up the next morning, I jumped in my car and I started driving out. And the only damage were a few downed trees and a few shingles off the roofs.
That's it?
That's it. And so our recovery was maybe a day.
Babcock Ranch was designed to accommodate Florida's ecosystem, with indigenous plants and natural waterways for drainage. It was built 25 to 30 feet above sea level to avoid storm surges. All electric and phone lines are buried.
Aren't you just lucky that you happen to be on a higher level than most of the parts of Florida that got washed away?
Yes, I think that's important. But not when it comes to the wind and flooding and rain. And so if that infrastructure is not built properly, you will have homes that get flooded. You will have that wind damage.
No one here lost power. Sid Kitson took us to see this massive solar array.
What you see is 440 acres.
700,000 panels built by Florida Power and Light. They withstood Ian's brutal battering.
There's a lot of water, but you don't see a single panel that's been dislodged. And there was quite a bit of wind that came through here over the last few days.
So gusts of 150 or more.
Gusts of over 150, and it did not take a single panel out of here, which is really just remarkable.
After seeing the devastation on Sanibel Island, it felt strange to see children playing in parks here, people enjoying themselves, eating at waterside restaurants, while neighboring communities struggle with Ian's aftermath, the deadliest hurricane since Katrina.